I know what she was thinking of me.
I'll tell you what I think of you. I don't care who you are. You're my daughter now. And Josie's my granddaughter, and that's all that matters to me. I knew all along you weren't Marcia, but it was nice to have a new family.
Oh, Lizzie, you're wonderful.
No, I'm not. I'm just a silly old goat who can't keep out of trouble.
You get a move on. You've been in here for ages.
Well, hold your horses.
Yeah, but you can't still hold that much, you know?
Well, look, these bags mean money to me. I've got to get as many as I can.
What are you doing here, Bryant?
Well, you know, just having a quiet stroll, Mr. Fletcher.
Yes, well, you should be with the others in the recreation room. Now get a move on.
Sure.
Might as well lock this now. It's almost dinner time.
Yes, you might as well.
Yes, well, I suppose you should continue painting in there, would you?
I suppose.
She didn't mean anything real bad. She was just worried about Josie. She said she was real good friends with my daughter right up until the time she died. So I reckon Marcy'd want me to help him. Anyway, I told her I knew all along she wasn't my real daughter, but it didn't make no difference. It'd be nice if they could stay on at your house, Doreen, just till I get out.
Oh, yeah, sure they can, Lizzie.
That's what I told him.
Oh, no, thanks, Lizzie. I don't really miss him.
No, I'm giving him up. Oh, come on, B. There's still a couple left, and Noeline will be here with some more very soon.
I'm not owing Noeline any favours.
What favours? Crikey, Lizzie had to pay $5 for that packet.
Yeah, and now she's only charging $2. I should have waited.
We go and troppo not having any telly or anything. Can't you do something about it?
Oh, sure. I could just wave me magic wand and we could have all our privileges back in 2 weeks. Would that be all right?
No, I was only asking.
Okay, Bev, give them back. You're not the racers now. Will you keep those out of sight?
Oh, you're nothing but a bunch of criminals.
Oh, come on, B. We haven't had a cigarette in ages.
I don't know what's wrong with you lot. You have your privileges taken away for a couple of weeks and you turn into a pack of lily-livered scroungers.
Yeah, why don't you go and buy yours from Noeline?
And that's another thing. You let a little weasel like Bourke rip you off just because you can't go 2 seconds without a fag hanging out of the corner of your mouth.
You're just helping her feather her own nest. Don't you realise that?
If you could hang out a bit longer, you'd teach little rats like her that they can't make a killing out of us every time we lose our privileges. Now, come on, have you got any willpower or not?
Well, it suits me, because I hardly ever smoke anymore anyway.
Well?
Yeah, okay. Oh,
it's much harder for an old woman like me.
Oh, Lizzie!
She's not coming.
Why not?
She's got locked in the storeroom.
Oh, so that's where she's been getting the stuff.
Well, look, they've locked the gates to administration. Now, how are we going to get her out?
You're the one that tied her to your apron strings. You figure it out.
But the screws will find out.
Yeah, what a shame.
Well, we've had muster, so they won't find out until we go to bed. You'll think of something, won't you, Bea?
Me? I'm not lifting a finger to help that little worm. And none of you are either.
Look, I'll get to your place a little bit early and give you a hand.
Oh, thanks. Not that I've asked many, but I still haven't finished unpacking.
Meg, I've just been told that Lizzie Birdsworth had a visit from her so-called daughter and granddaughter. Why wasn't I telling?
Well, there didn't seem much point.
Oh, well, the last I heard they were leaving town. What did they want?
Well, to tell Lizzie the truth. But she said she knew all along, didn't make the slightest bit of difference.
What about Lizzie's compensation?
Well, I've got the feeling that the money doesn't mean quite so much anymore.
It's one thing I like about being a social worker. People are constantly surprising me.
These women want to work things out for themselves. They don't want any help.
Oh, thank you, Miss Bennett. You've just put me in the redundant bin. Can I offer you ladies a lift?
No, thank you. I've got some shopping to do. See you later, Meg.
Well, I won't say no.
Where's Bourke? Well?
Oh, she's lying down. She said she wasn't hungry.
Yeah, she must have been gorging herself with all those biscuits she got at the buyer.
Served her right for not sharing.
Yes, well, you're all on loss of privileges. She had no right sharing them. What's the matter, Smith? Not hungry? Or has Bourke been passing something on to you?
The only thing she'd pass on would be a bad taste, like this muck you're trying to poison us with.
Well, at least Noeline won't be starving, eh? Not with all those cookies and candy she's got stuck away with her. Yeah, they sure would be nice later on with coffee, wouldn't they? Funny how you can get attached to little things like that.
Yes, isn't it?
We're out of coffee, too.
There'll be plenty in the storeroom.
Oh, yeah. Oh, except I'm on a diet. For Kevin, you know? I've already lost quite a bit of weight since the last buy-up.
I'm sure he likes you the way you are, honey.
You reckon?
Yeah. Oh, dear. Sure gonna be hard for you smokers, isn't it? Trying to get by without a fag. Nothing to take your mind off it. No telly, even. And that last cigarette before you go to bed at night, eh, Lizzie?
So take up nail biting.
It's easy for you, isn't it? You're stronger than the others. Look, I don't think it's fair for you to put these women through this just because you don't like Noeline.
Okay, I'll give you a hand. For a price. Noeline gives us everything she's managed to get those grubby little hands of hers on, and we don't have to pay her 1 cent.
What?
It's that or no deal.
Yeah, okay, that's a deal.
How are we going to do it, V?
I'll sleep on it.
We got to get her out of there tonight.
We can cover for her until morning. Won't hurt that little rat this widow are.
Might teach her a lesson.
You better go and change. I'll finish setting things up.
All right, then. You'll find everything somewhere.
Does that go on all the time?
Enough. That's the girl I was telling you about. You know, the one with the three small children?
Well, look, it shouldn't be allowed.
Pardon?
It shouldn't be allowed in flats.
Oh, they have to try occasionally.
Well, if she couldn't keep it quiet, I'd soon report her.
Oh, they're only babies, Vera. You know, I feel a bit sorry for her. But she's doing her best.
Do you know where the corkscrew is?
Oh, I think it's in one of the top of those boxes. Don't tell me they're arriving already.
I'll get it.
Well, I won't be long.
Yes?
Oh, I'm sorry. I was looking for Mrs. Jackson.
Well, I'm afraid she's getting dressed at the moment.
Oh, could you ask if I could borrow a couple of eggs, please? I'll pay him back. I was getting my husband's tea ready and Stevie started up. When I went to see if he was okay, Jason knocked them on the floor.
Gail, hello.
Oh, hello, Meg. Could I borrow a couple of eggs, please?
Oh, sure. Come on in. I'll get them for you.
Thanks. Tim would have a pink fit if his tea wasn't ready on time. Oh, I didn't know you're having friends in.
Oh, there's no problem. Look, why don't you slip in later for a drink? Perhaps your husband can look after the children for half an hour. Give you a bit of a break.
Oh, thanks anyway, but I don't reckon Tim would be too keen on that.
All right. Well, you see how you go.
You're a lifesaver, Meg. I'll pay him back first thing tomorrow.
Okay.
Do you think that was very wise?
What? Asking her in?
If you get too friendly with your neighbours, they'll start living in your pocket.
Oh, Vera, 5 minutes break would do her the world of good. Anyway, she won't be coming.
It's a good boy, open wide. Katrina, will you stop playing with your food? Look, if you don't want to finish it, then see if you can get Stevie to finish his. Mummy doesn't go out too often, so I don't want you two kicking up a fuss. I'll leave a note for Dad on the table. His tea will be in the oven. Well, he can't yell at us if everything's okay, can he? I haven't been to a party since before you were born, Stevie. Now, La Web. Oh, hell.
eat your food.
You want to grow big and strong like your dad, don't you? Katrina, if you want to colour in and do it in here, love. Don't want the light waking up the boys. Don't go messing up the room again.
Bryant?
Just seeing if Noeline's okay.
Vera. I hardly recognized you. That's very becoming.
Thank you.
Must be very difficult on the female staff not being allowed to be more flexible with the way they dress.
The regulations state that the hair should be up and off the face and makeup kept to a minimum. I agree with that. We work in a prison, not a beauty parlor.
Jim, can I get you anything?
No, I'm fine, thanks, mate. It's a nice flat.
Yes, it will be when I finished it. It's much smaller than the unit, but I mainly needed a change of scenery, I think.
Suppose you left quite a few memories behind, eh?
Some. Only the ones I wanted to.
Yeah, that's easier said than done.
I know. But I'm glad you came.
Yes, I've been spending a bit too much time living in the past. It doesn't bring them back, does it? Trouble is, sometimes it's just hard to remember their faces.
Excuse me.
Jim, why don't you come over here and join us?
Oh, thanks.
Gail! I'm glad you could make it. Come on in.
Tim's not back yet, but I put the kids down and I'll keep checking on them.
I don't see why we should help Noeline Burke's family when she doesn't care about them herself.
She refuses to accept welfare checks.
I'd like you to meet Vera Bennett, Paul Reed, Jim Fletcher. This is Gail Summers, my next door neighbor.
Okay. Yeah.
Can I get you a drink?
Oh, Moselle?
Right.
You all work with Meg?
Most of us do. The sane-looking couple in the corner, they don't.
Oh, one of those places would be nice to visit, but you wouldn't want to live there, eh?
Why don't we sit down?
As we were saying, Paul, they may be too proud to accept welfare. They're not too proud to commit a crime any time they feel like it.
Vera, I am concerned about the children.
They'd be better off in a home. It's disgusting.
I feel like putting mine in a home sometimes. And I've only got three. Still, they're pretty close together.
They shouldn't have children if they can't cope with them.
What are you suggesting, Vera? You stop people from having kids altogether?
No. No, just in cases like that. They should be taken out of the environment so at least they can have a chance.
And what I can't figure out is why Judy is so keen on keeping Bourke out of strife.
Yeah. She doesn't even smoke anymore since she had that thingamajig put in her ticker. Sure you wouldn't like a puff bee? It's the last one.
Will you shut up about it? I told you I was giving him up, and I meant it.
Well, maybe she's doing it for us. I can't wait until tomorrow night to have a cup of coffee and something to dunk in it.
What about your diet?
Oh, yeah.
She can't still be feeling guilty about Leanne's death. Anyone only has to look at Bourke to see she's forgotten she even had a daughter.
Well, maybe she's putting up a tough front.
Noeline's tough front goes all the way through to her back. Judy's got something up her sleeve. And I'd like to know what it is.
Wait, just a minute. I'm serious. Just because they're prison buildings, why do they have to be so austere?
Because it's a prison, not a holiday resort.
Don't you think being locked up is punishment enough about it having to look like the Tower of London?
Yeah, but the trouble is, if you give them anything decent, they just destroy it, don't they?
They don't appreciate anything.
Well, they might if we gave them something to appreciate. Mm.
Oh, I must say the atmosphere does get you down after a while.
But at least we can walk out of it every day.
Yeah. It must be awful. Yeah.
You learn to switch off.
Oh, you wouldn't think so, the way we've been talking about work all night.
No, Joyce doesn't. You should hear her when she comes home. Put out the rubbish, wash the car, do this, do that. Anybody think I was one of the inmates?
Oh, and you love it. That's why he married me. He likes the domineering type.
I'm thinking of a change.
Oh, are you?
It's the gentler variety. But a woman like you doesn't take it all so seriously, Vera.
Oh, you have to.
Well, you can't be as bad as some of them Joyce has told me about. What was the name of that singer old?
Oh, I suppose we all get too involved from time to time. It's only natural. I mean, some of the things we see and hear.
But if it's so awful, why do you all work there?
It's a job like anything else. The reasons aren't important as long as you're good at it.
Oh, excuse me.
That's probably a complaint. I can see it all now. Headlight, prison officer.
My wife,
oh, you must be Gail's husband.
All right, you see him. What do you mean by leaving the kids on the road, eh?
I looked in on him.
Well, you're going to sit around here chatting all night? Do you reckon you get back in there and do what you're supposed to be doing? The place is a bloody pigsty.
Please, Tim, not here.
Can I get you a drink?
No, thanks. We're just leaving.
I told you not to get too involved with your neighbours.
Well, here's to my new house.
Oh, yes. Yes. Good luck. Little mouse, don't take all day.
Are you deaf, Bourke? Now get out of that bed at once.
Well, thank you, Smith.
Any time, Fletch.
For this little stunt, you can all have extra duties in the laundry.
Oh, come, Moffat. We're already on extra time. You can't blame this lot for being towy with no privileges.
Yeah. And you'll keep on getting extra duties until you can learn to behave. Now get moving, or you won't get your showers either.
Oh, sir, I will.
You feeling all right?
It's just a headache.
Wouldn't be a hangover by any chance, would it, Vera?
Of course not. I was all right until that little ruckus.
What do you want me to do for Fran, Allah? Be here every second.
Oh, see why you can't ever bring her home sometimes.
How can I relax with you whinging and the kids screaming to a bear all the time?
Well, I don't think it's going to be more fun with them, that's all.
But other wives don't need their husbands doing every bloody thing for them. What makes you bloody useless?
Morning. Oh, Meg. Listen, I'm sorry about last night.
Oh, don't worry about it.
You got time for a cup of coffee?
Oh, no, I really do have to get to work.
All right. Just for a minute.
Lizzie!
Sit down. Sorry about the mess. Was tidy. But when Katrina and Jason get together, it's like a bomb's hit. Katrina, will you see if you can keep Stevie quiet while I heat his bottle?
How are you going, Jace?
Oh, he doesn't say much. But he's so affectionate, you know. Hardly leaves me alone for a second. I don't know. The other two were never like him. Sometimes you just wonder what you're doing wrong.
Well, some babies cry more than others, that's all.
Yeah. Tim reckons I don't pay him enough attention. But I tell him, spend more time with him than the other two put together. It makes no difference. But he never listens. Men.
They'd soon find out if they had to look after them by themselves for a few days.
Yeah, that's why I keep telling him.
What have you got here, eh? Let's have a look at all this. My goodness, you have been in the wars, young man, haven't you?
Oh, them. It's got to be the clumsiest kid I know. Well, if he's not fallen over, he and Katrina are always laying into one another.
Have you got any family or friends that could, well, give you a break for a couple of hours?
Oh, Tim would only reckon I wasn't pulling me weight.
Well, we all need time by ourselves.
Yeah, I know. Well, he doesn't mean half what he says. Well, it's not easy for him, paying off this place and feeding three kids on factory pay. Well, Katrina and Jason, they aren't even his. Oh, not that he doesn't like them, mind you. It's just that, well, he's not as close to them as he could be.
Oh,
What's the matter with your friend Bourke?
I don't know. She must have been hungry.
She must have read the menu.
You shut up. They're getting suspicious, and it's only half an hour to muster.
Okay, let's go.
I still reckon you should let me do it. I've had more practice than the whole lot of you put together.
That's why it would look better if it wasn't you this time. We can't all get it.
It's okay, Lizzie. I've been watching you real good. You look.
Hey, what's the matter, love? What's the matter with you, Burns?
I feel real crook, Miss Bennett.
Yeah, come to think of it, I don't feel too good myself.
What do you do to the food, Vera? Poison it? Don't talk rubbish, Smith. There's nothing wrong with the food.
Yeah, that's not the message I'm getting.
Well, I told you that stuff tasted off. You had to shovel it all into you. There's nothing wrong with the food. Well, it smells perfectly all right to me.
Then you eat it.
Come on, Miss Bennett. Eat mine. There's nothing wrong with mine.
Come on.
Anybody else feeling ill? I better take them to the dispensary, just in case.
I'll do it. I was going down that way anyway.
I hear the dog's the best cure, Miss Bennett. All right, all those feeling sick, fall out.
You know, girls, I have got a damn good chance of suing this dump.
Oh, yeah.
Well, don't be ridiculous. You probably just caught a virus.
Thank you, Florence Nightingale.
You all think that's funny. You're probably not very sick.
Oh, I've already heard my laugh.
Report to muster and then get to work.
Come on,
as much as I can take too, Miss Bennett.
I want to lie down.
You may not be well enough to work in the laundry, but there's nothing stopping you working on these things.
I'm as weak as a kitten.
You were only given an emetic. It'll pass.
Yeah, we noticed.
We must have been better actors than we thought.
Oh, Lizzie would have been proud of us.
Yeah, but why did they have to believe we had food poisoning? I feel as though I've thrown up all last night's dinner as well.
Yeah,
well,
at least it'll be good for your diet. Rightio, shop's open. 10 cents a fag, 5 cents a biscuit, and a coffee to the highest bidder.
Haven't you heard? You're giving them away.
Oh, go to hell, no freebies. You don't think we went through that because we like you, do you, Bourke? Oh, what are you trying to put over me? I could have walked out of there any time I liked. I was just waiting for the right time.
Well, we spoke to your manager. Tell her, Judy.
Good on you, baby. Good on you. I'm going to get you for this, Smith.
I'll be waiting.
You see, we're not accepting this sticking up for Bourke because you feel you owe a routine any longer. So are you going to come clean or do I have to forget I'm a lady?
Okay, it's no big deal. I just feel sorry for her, that's all.
Bull.
Honest. Reed told her that if her family won't accept welfare, they're going to put those kids in a home. She's got 4 brothers and sisters under the age of 18 and a kid of her own. She's only trying to scrounge up a bit of money to keep out of strife.
Now, would you like to try again, or do I have to break your arm?
Oh, damn. I want the money for myself. I was going to wait till she gets a bundle and then clean her out.
Now, that's more like it, but why?
I want it for when I get out.
Why don't you save up like the rest of us? You'd have a fair bit saved by the time they released you.
Because I'm not planning on being here that long.
If you're talking about escaping, you're out of your mind. We've all tried that. All it gets you is more time.
Well, that's a risk I'm willing to take.
All right, then. That's your funeral. But I'll tell you something. I don't care if you rob Bourke blind, but you try and make a fast buck out of us and you're going to have me to answer to. So you just find some other way to get rich quick. Not out of us. Do you get it?
Will you put that away? Why?
Because Bourke could just take it into her mind to lag.
She'd be dobbing herself in. She wouldn't do it.
You wouldn't want to bet, would you?
This keeps up, I'll be able to retire. Only 2 have managed to back this so far. Even then, it was only a dollar down.
Quick, Governor. Which pot was used for the women for breakfast this morning?
That one.
Mrs. Davidson.
Mrs. Davidson. They said the sausages were off. Cook's not going to be too pleased. You guys saying her snags were off.
We've already spoken to her.
She said you did most of the cooking this morning.
What are you trying to say?
That's enough. They seem all right, but it only takes one or two for the whole lot to be tainted. Where's the order book?
Them snags were fresh in yesterday.
I gave Smith and her lot extra duties this morning. They could have been faking just to get out of work.
I hardly think they'd go through an emetic for that, Miss Bennett. Right, thank you. Carry on.
Well, come on. You should be setting the tables for lunch by now.
I suppose I could have a word with the butchers, but they've always been so reliable in the past.
There's nothing crook about that food.
Bourke, if you know something, I suggest you tell me.
All I know is that for somebody who'd lost their buy-up privileges, Smith's lot sure seemed to have a lot of stuff stashed away for a rainy day.
What's that got to do with the food?
Dunno. Why don't you ask them?
I'm asking you. Why are you telling us this?
Because them rotten sods pinched all me stuff that I got from the buy-up, that's why.
Why didn't you report it straight away?
Because a screw would only turn a blind eye.
If you are telling the truth, I assure you they would be punished in exactly the same way as if they'd stolen from the prison itself. Miss Bennett, will you organise the search, please? I have an appointment in 15 minutes.
No, no, it's not for me, it's for a friend. Well, I'm sure she'd be much more interested in playgroups at the moment. Now, she has two boys. One's about three and the other one's a baby. Oh, well, we didn't really want anything too expensive. Right. All right, that sounds wonderful. Right. Thank you very much.
I didn't know you were taking over Paul Reed's job.
How do you think I'll go?
It's no joking, Madam Meg. If you want to make personal phone calls, do it at home.
Oh, Vera, don't be such a bore. Look, my phone's not connected. I had 5 minutes to spare, and I'm sure even the rules allow an officer one phone call a week.
Well, if you can spare me 5 minutes, you might like to help me in a search. Bourke claims the women have taken some of her last buy-up items.
Well, the front gate just rang. I have to show a gentleman through to Mrs. Davidson.
Let someone else do it. This is much more important.
This way, sir.
Oh, excuse me, Miss Bennett. Mr. Reynolds?
Yes,
right. Mrs. Davidson's expecting you. Well, if you'd just sign on, I'll take you through to her.
Yes, of course.
Could you show him through, please?
This way, sir.
Thank you.
Now, I let you get away with that because I didn't want to show him just how petty some of us can be. But don't ever do that to me again, Vera.
She goes and shoots off her mouth and you're just going to take it.
That's right. You're just telling me what I knew all along.
But that bitch has already tried pinching me bookie money. No one can feel safe with her around.
Just give her enough rope to hang herself with.
And what about her? Always pussyfooting around after Bourke.
She's with us.
What are you doing in here, Gaffney?
Just telling these liars the next time they want to complain about the cooking, I'll give them something to complain about.
You're like making us eat the slop she dishes up.
Just a minute.
Stop what you're doing and stand against the wall.
What? What's going on?
Just do what you're told, Smith.
What's this about?
Go on, back to the kitchen.
I'm going to be sick. Can I go to the bathroom?
You know, if you'd told us what you were looking for, we might have been able to help you. Watch the door.
Well, looks like this calls for a celebration.
Coffee, anyone?
We have had work release programs before, although not on the scale you're talking about. They are not without their problems.
I'd like to apply the same setup as the Parramatta Linen Service. Say, half a dozen women, 3 days a week at $40 each. Thank you.
Well, I would have to check the rate of pay, but it does sound as though you've done your research.
Well, in the clothing trade, if you don't keep up with the trends, you might as well shut up shop.
Not many businesses employ ex-prisoners, let alone those who are still serving time.
Well, I trust you'll only send me the most reliable women.
That will be after the classification committee. But you do understand why I find it unusual, Mr. Reynolds.
Look, it's not out of the goodness of my heart. You see, my company won't be able to meet this government order without a solid backup team. I mean, it's difficult enough finding experienced machinists and cutters without this sudden increase in output.
Well, I would have to see the factory first before giving this more thought.
Oh, yes, yes, of course. I mean, we'll meet whatever requirements you think are necessary. I mean, separate work areas, facilities. Without appearing too eager, would this afternoon be suitable? I'll send a car to pick you up.
Oh, that will not be necessary. It would have to be after 5.
Hmm. Marvellous.
When are you going to learn to keep your big mouth shut?
They checked Smith in the pen?
No. They didn't find anything. And they're not going to either.
She lays a hand on me, the screws will know why.
She won't. But you know, you're not going to even be able to sneeze without her knowing about it now.
How am I going to get the dough from her family?
Well, she won't be watching me.
So?
You still got that $5 you got from Lizzie?
Yeah. So what?
Well, I think you ought to place a little bet on the Gigi's.
Yeah, that's a mug's game.
Come on, Noeline, listen to me, huh? Now, you said yourself, Margot has got a lot of money stashed away somewhere, right? She's going to have to put your bet with it. And when she does, I'm going to be there watching her.
Oh, yeah. Hey, you know, you should look me up when you get out of here. I reckon we make a real good team.
Yeah.
Have you read this?
Hmm.
Well, she can't be serious. One minute they're all on loss of privileges, the next minute she's talking about letting them out on work release.
There's nothing definite yet. Mrs. Davidson just wants us to think about it.
I already have.
Well, I haven't. Now, I'm going home now to do some more unpacking, then I'll settle down, and then I'll think about it.
Well, it's a wonder you can do that with all that crying going on next door.
Oh, yes. I'll be seeing Gail again tonight.
Well, it's obvious she doesn't know how to bring up children. A good smack, and they'd soon learn to be quiet.
Vera, you don't know anything about her or the situation.
I've seen what her husband's like. And if you involve yourself, he's just the type to turn nasty.
If I can help that girl, I will.
Oh, Mrs. Davidson, it's about this work release program. There's not one amongst them you can trust, and you're talking about at least 6. They'll have to be constantly supervised, and not to mention the transport problems.
It will be the same as supervising them in here. It won't mean any extra duties for the officers, and I'm sure the department can spare the funds to hire a bus.
You sound as if you've already made up your mind.
We can discuss it at the meeting tomorrow. It's pointless doing it now before I've seen the factory.
But after this morning's little episode...
Well, may have been lying, but knowing how well the women can hide things, it wouldn't hurt to keep an eye on them. And if they do have the items, at least we're not giving them the opportunity to enjoy them.
Ah, hi.
Hi. I didn't forget him.
Well, there was no rush. I wanted to catch up with you later anyway. Have you got a few minutes to spare?
I've got to get back to the shops before they shut. I don't know. Every time I go shopping, I'm always forgetting something. So busy keeping the kids out of trouble, and then they start screaming, and oh, I can't wait to get out of the place. But I just put Stevie down, and Katrina will be okay for a couple of minutes, so I just got this one to keep an eye on.
And why don't you leave him with me? It would really give you a clear run.
Oh, I don't know. He can be a bit of a handful.
I don't mind. I can manage.
Well, if you're sure, that'll be great.
Come on, Jason.
You be a good boy for Mrs. Jackson.
We'll get along just fine.
Oh, thanks, Meg.
Oh, we'll have that chat when you come back, okay?
Okay, see you later.
Bye. Well, been a long time since I've had a 3-year-old running around the place. Now, what are we going to do, eh? Well, I know what Marty liked to do when he was your age. Let's have a look at that arm. I wonder whether you really are as clumsy as your mother says. Hope that's all she's little fella.
I don't see any difficulty with the area you have in mind at all. In fact, to be perfectly honest, the women will be working in far better conditions than they've been used to.
Well, I think we've come a long way since the Industrial Revolution.
I see you concentrate on large orders.
It forms the main part of our output, yes. And it's where the money is. Although I do manage to keep some of the more exclusive lines going. A small indulgence of mine. Reminds me of when I used to work in Europe, when one design meant one garment, not 1,000.
Did you ever get to Paris?
I studied design there for 3 years.
Oh.
You know it?
It's one of my favorite cities.
I have a word with you, Mr. Reynolds. It's urgent.
Oh, yes, Vince. Vince Talbot, Mrs. Davidson. Vince is my foreman. He'll be keeping an eye on things. And you couldn't ask for better.
Mr. Talbot?
I did it.
Would you excuse us for a moment?
Yes, of course.
The union won't be happy getting in scab labor.
Now, look, Vince, you know as well as I do, I've already had it out with the unions. They weren't too happy at first, but I've smoothed things out. So don't rock the boat.
Yeah, well, some of the women have been grumbling already. I don't like being undercut by a bunch of crims.
They'll have as little to do with them as possible, and it's your job to keep the peace, Vince.
Yeah, well, they see it as a takeover.
But, oh, that's rubbish, and you know it. Now, look, if we don't fill that order, we go broke, and then everybody's out of a job. We need those prisoners, Vince. Now, just remember that.
Where is he?
Well, see for yourself. He's been helping me in the kitchen.
Come on, mate. Look, do me a favour, eh? Next time my wife asks you to look after the kids, tell her you're too busy, will you?
Mr. Summers, you can't expect Gail to stay locked up in a small flat with three young children 24 hours of the day.
Look, what I don't expect your so-called bloody neighbours sticking their noses in where they're not wanted.
You're home early?
Yeah, which is more than I can say for you.
Thanks, Meg. Must had a good time. He's out like a light.
Why do we need all this?
Was on special.
And the soup?
You like soup, Tim. Oh, I forgot.
Look, I am working like a dog to pay for this lousy place. Do you think I do shift work because I like it? I mean, this place may not be much, but it's the best thing you're ever going to have, and you can't even bloody well look after it. Or you don't care.
Oh, I'm doing me best, Tim, honest.
A simple thing like shopping and you louse it up. I mean, anybody with half a brain could do it. You leave the kids at home or you dump them on the neighbours.
It was only for a minute. I just wanted to get them out of the road.
What difference does that make? I mean, you can't even bloody get the shopping right.
Well, I was tired. I wasn't thinking straight, all right?
Tired? What do you do around here that makes you tired? I mean, look at this place. Well, you're not exactly busting a gut around here, are you?
Can't you understand? I just need you to help me sometimes, that's all.
Now look what you went and done.
You're the one that's
bad. Yeah, well, don't just stand there. Go and see what's wrong.
Why can't you do it?
Look, I do my fair share around here. Don't you worry about that.
What have you ever done for this? Yeah?
Yeah, well, someone's got to do it because you're so bloody useless. Every time I come home, it's the same old thing. Well, I've just about had it with you. With the love of you.
Doctors Wright and Brown to casualty, please. Doctors Wright and Brown.
Gail? How is he?
I'd like to keep him under observation overnight in case of concussion.
Will he be all right?
I think so. It's very lucky, though. A bump like that, he could have very easily fractured his skull. You say he fell out of his bed.
Well, he could have hit his head on the leg. And we don't have carpet on the floor. I just found him lying there.
All right, Mrs. Summers. We'll take good care of him.
Did Tim go into the children's room before he left?
I think he went in to tell him to shut up.
You're going to be all right on your own.
Oh, Tim will be back later. He's always walking out. And he has a few drinks with his mates and he'll be back. Oh, geez, he's going to be angry when he finds out about Jason.
Has he ever hit you or the children?
Once or twice. Oh, but he doesn't mean it. His bark's worse than his bite.
Do you reckon that Judy's still in with Noeline, B?
I see. Judy's not the type that throws the towel in that easily. $5 on fiery fidget and a 50.
At 50 to 1, it's like taking sweets from a baby.
I got it straight from the horse's mouth.
I want to be able to see my face in these floors this afternoon, Beck.
Yeah, I'd like to see it there too.
I've got to go to the loo, Miss Bennett.
You haven't finished in here yet, can't it wait?
Only if you want me to embarrass myself.
Hurry up.
We'll soon see if Judy's giving Bourke a helping hand.
Tim's hardly ever looked after the kids before. Oh, I don't know why it has to take something like this before he'll... He does love them, you know. It's just that... Well, some men don't know how to show it. Oh, and I know I don't help much nagging him all the time, but I just can't stop myself. Sometimes it just gets me down.
You're not the only one who'd feel like that. Look, have you ever thought about joining a play group? They're run by mothers, just like yourself. They're good fun, and the children have others to play with. Now, I've made a few inquiries.
Hello, darling. Oh, you gave Mummy such a scare.
We gave Jason a thorough examination, Mrs. Summers. You didn't mention that he'd broken his arm recently.
Oh, well, he's always tripping over his feet. But Dr. Whitlow said it was mending okay.
He's the family doctor.
I've been to him a few times.
We also found some bruising.
Oh, that's nothing. He's always getting into scraps with his sister, aren't you?
Well, you just try and keep a good eye out for him in future, huh?
Thanks, Doctor.
Gail, could you just wait downstairs for a minute? I just want to ring work and tell them where I am. Excuse me, Doctor.
I'm Mrs. Summers, next door neighbour. Now, I know you can't discuss your patients, but I just don't believe that Jason is accident prone.
Do you have any reason to believe otherwise?
Well, I've only just moved in, but... All right. Now, I know it's a serious accusation, but I believe that Jason's been abused by his stepfather.
Stepfather? What about the other two kiddies?
They seem fine.
Ah, it's usually the way. One child bears the brunt.
Well, is there anything that you can do? Or me?
Well, I had intended going to the family doctor. We could build up a case. But the trouble with child abuse, if that's what we're dealing with here, is it's very hard to prove anything in the initial stages.
Initial stages?
Unless the child has a history of unexplained accidents, or a witness can testify that he's seen the child actually abused. Very difficult to do anything at all. Some of the time, we're too late.
You and Beck at Bourke must think we was born yesterday.
I don't know what you're talking about.
She gave herself away when she put a fiver on a nag that'll come home a day late. Now even Bourke isn't that stupid. Bee's gonna be real pleased to hear about this, I'd reckon. Yeah, real pleased.
He used to give me roses. I wish he could again. But that was on the outside. and things were different then. On the inside, the sun still shines.